Also today, big news coming from former President Donald Trump. He commuted the sentence of former Detroit Mayor Kwame Kilpatrick.
In granting clemency, Trump concluded that Kilpatrick had paid his dues and that he was not a threat to society, but still required him to pay nearly $5 million in restitution.
So what's next for the former mayor? Our team coverage begins with 7 Action News reporter Jim Kurtzner, who has that side of the story.
Priority one will be reuniting with his family and his 3 sons. That's in other states. Here in Detroit, this is an election year. Kilpatrick can't run for mayor now, but he could influence the voters and back a candidate.
Detroit Mayor Mike Duggan tweeting out this morning, Kwame Kilpatrick is a person of great talent who still has much to contribute. I know how close he is to his 3 sons, and I could not be happier for them being together again. This is a decision President Trump got right. The mayor declined an interview. Kilpatrick supporters say the former mayor is a force.
If he weighs in, he's going to have impact, and the current mayor knows that. And so that's why even he said that the president made the right decision.
President Trump does not let Kilpatrick walk free and clear. Trump leaves intact $4.7 million in restitution, $2,500 in a special assessment, and 3 years supervised release, probation in the federal system, which will include conditions.
Do you want him to pay?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, he robbed the money from the people of the city of Detroit. He stole the money from the city. He should pay every dime of it back.
Trump also wrote in the clemency order that the ends of justice do not require Kilpatrick to stay in prison until his projected release date of 2037. Trump said the safety of the community will not be compromised if Kilpatrick is released. In 2010, Michigan passed a constitutional amendment that bans convicted public officials from running for state or local office for 20 years. Kilpatrick has 13 more years to go.
I would like to see him any leadership capacity that he would like to be in.
He could run for Congress now, as a matter of fact, because that is not a federal ban.
The next election for Congress is next year, 2022. In downtown, Jim Kurtzner, 7 Action News.
Thank you so much, Jim.